Good morning. Today we are going to learn how to use cardinal directions with vectors. Here we go.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
In our previous lesson, we did an example where we added two velocity vectors A and B together to get the resultant velocity vector R of our slow velocity racer. Our answer was 65 millimeters per second at an angle of 41 degrees east of north. Today, we're going to learn why this angle theta is east of north.
Thanks.
Agreed.
However, before we do, I need to remind you that I am spelling impaired. It is really difficult for me to spell words.
No, you really can't spell.
Yep, I have a really hard time spelling. I admit it, and I work with it. Some of you need to admit that you are directionally impaired.
I'm not directionally impaired.
Yes. A lot of students struggle with cardinal directions. Because of your possible directional impairment, I have two suggestions. One, always draw this compass rose on any sheet of paper where you are working with cardinal directions. Just like this, only smaller. Second, never turn the sheet of paper that you're working with. Always keep it oriented vertically. The moment you begin to turn your paper, we all get confused.
Because it's confusing if north is not always forward relative to you.
Now, let's talk about how I identify this angle here, theta of 41 degrees, to be east of north. So this angle right here is angle theta east of north, same theta and also east of north. I've also drawn a small compass rose on the tail of our resultant vector R, which is something that I do suggest that you do if you are struggling with cardinal directions. I do think that people find it easier rather than thinking of it as of, but rather from, because that's what the of means in this particular case. This angle theta is 41 degrees east from north. In other words, you're moving the direction of east from the northward direction, eastward from north. Billy, what then is the direction of this angle?
That would be north of east.
Correct. This angle is north of east. And Bobby, how should we describe this angle?
West from north. West of north.
Correct. This angle is west from north. And Bo, what about this angle?
South of west.
Correct. This angle is south of west. We're moving southward from west. And Bobby, how would we describe this angle?
North of south.
Bobby, actually, north of south doesn't work. This direction would be north of south, but this direction also would be northward from south. So that doesn't really work. So Bobby, please try again.
West of south.
There you go, Bobby. Yes, that is west of south. Bo, how about this one?
That's north of west.
Yes, that is north of west or northward from west. And Bobby, what about this angle?
South of east.
Correct, this is southward from east or south of east. And Billy, how about this last one?
That one is east of south.
Yes, the last direction is east of south. And you can now see on the board in red are eight options for describing the direction of an angle using cardinal directions. Now, let's return back to our original resultant vector, which was 65 millimeters per second and an angle of 41 degrees east of north. There is actually a second equivalent way to describe the direction of this resultant vector. We could describe this resultant vector with what other equivalent angle?
It's 49 degrees north of east.
Correct. We could also describe this vector as 65 millimeters per second and an angle of 49 degrees north of east. And Bobby, how did you get 49 degrees?
Well, 41 and 49 degrees are complementary angles.
What do you mean, complementary angles?
They add up to 90 degrees.
Correct. North and east are 90 degrees relative to one another. Therefore, these two angles are going to be complementary to one another. Therefore, this angle right here is going to be 90 minus 41 degrees. One other small thing. Sometimes you'll see NESESW or NW. They mean northeast, southeast, southwest, and northwest. And they mean actually a specific direction. So it means exactly 45 degrees between the two directions.
So then northeast could be 45 degrees east of north or 45 degrees north of east.
Correct, but generally people will write southwest, for example, rather than 45 degrees south of west. Let's do a quick review. Please always draw a compass rose on your sheet of paper whenever working with cardinal directions. If you're having issues, it's always good, too, to draw a small compass rose at the tail of any vector you're trying to figure out the angle of. We have our 8 choices for our cardinal directions, and rather than east of north, it's actually easier to think of it as east from north. In other words, eastward from north. Oh, and don't forget your complementary angles. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.